Now let's talk about a wave and how it propagates. If we had a direction x and we had a sinusoidal wave, it would propagate something like this as a function of time. We could describe this wave, which we're going to call y, as a function of x and t, as amplitude times the cosine of omega t minus beta x plus phi. And that would be our wave. In this case, y would be the amplitude of that, would be the amplitude of that wave as a function of distance and time. A would be the amplitude, the maximum value that that could be reached. So this is the amplitude, and it's also the max of that wave. Omega is the angular frequency. Omega is 2 pi times the frequency given in hertz, and that's also equal to 2 pi divided by the period. The period of the wave, if we drew it as if we drew it in time, here's a time picture of this wave. So right now what I'm going to do is choose one point. Let's choose that point right there. We're just going to draw that wave as a function of time. It has its amplitude, and this right here is the period of that wave. And that period would be given in seconds or some other measurement of time. So omega is given in radians per second. The frequency is given in hertz, which is just 1 per second. So omega is radians per second, f is hertz or inverse seconds, and t, the period, is given in seconds. Beta is our propagation constant. Beta is given in radians per meter, and that is equal to 2 pi divided by the wavelength. The wavelength is given in meters. Right here on our distance plot, this is meters, this represents the wavelength of our wave. So beta is radians per meter, wavelength here is meters, and beta is our propagation constant. The last variable that we have here is phi. Phi is given in radians, and that tells us something about the shift of the wave. We'll be talking about waves that lead and lag in a minute. So let's take a look at what this generally means. Right here we have a wave that's propagating as a function of time and as a function of distance. The negative sign right there, that negative sign tells me that it's going in the positive x direction. If it were a positive sign, that would mean that the wave was going in the negative x direction. So we have a wave with an amplitude of a, propagating with a frequency omega in the x direction with a phase of phi. Now here's a picture of this wave, both as a function of distance and as a function of time. Right here, is this a cosine wave or a sine wave? This is our cosine wave. It's starting right there at its maximum amplitude, and it's moving in space. What that means is that at some instant of time, this value is zero, this value is maximum, this value is zero. Right here, we can see that the wave repeats every wavelength. So here's the repeat point. This point is the same as this point A. So the wave repeats every wavelength. A wavelength is 2 pi radians, or 360 degrees. Over here on the time sample, we're going to look at this point right here where x is equal to 0, and we can see that it starts out at its maximum value and it decreases and increases and decreases and increases and decreases. It repeats every period, and a period is also 360 degrees or 2 pi radians.